In previous videos, we discussed how important web page performance is to the success of your site. Gatsby is one of those frameworks that I've worked with recently that has put a big focus on performance from the ground up. Today, I'm going to go over how to set up the infrastructure in AWS to host a Gatsby site. Hi, I'm Phil Sparks with Guiding Digital. I spent 20 years working in an enterprise IT shop, and during that time, my most rewarding role was the lead programmer on a web development team. I love being able to mentor other developers and help them grow. That's the primary reason I started my Guiding Digital business and YouTube channel. I want to come alongside web developers, marketers, and small business owners and help you grow in your web development and digital marketing skills. So if this interests you, subscribe below to stay informed about future content. In today's video, we're going to set up the basic infrastructure needed to host a Gatsby site in AWS using an S3 bucket and a Cloudfront distribution. And then in future videos, we'll go over the more advanced options to make it production ready. I'll be using Gatsby in this video, but the solution we set up today applies to any statically generated site. If you want to follow along with today's demo, make sure that you have an account set up with AWS that has permissions to create resources, and make sure to install the Gatsby framework. So let's get started. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is create the S3 bucket. We're going to go into the AWS console and go to the S3 management console and click the Create Bucket button. And then we're going to enter a bucket name. And then click Create. Then we're going to go back into our bucket. And the first thing we're going to do is set the permissions. In order to use an S3 bucket as an origin for your CloudFront distribution, you've got to give the anonymous user public access. By default, AWS blocks all public access. And so you first got to uncheck this block all public access checkbox and hit Save. And then just enter Confirm. And confirm they really do want to allow public access to this bucket. The next thing we need to do is set our bucket policy. To do that, click on the bucket policy tab, and then you can get it down to the bottom of this page, and there's a link to their documentation page. And on that page, they have example policies you can copy and paste. So I'll go to the example policies and then scroll down and use this one that says grant read-only permission to an anonymous user. So go ahead and copy that and paste it into our policy editor. And the only thing we have to change is the bucket name. Just set that to your bucket name. And hit save. The next thing we need to do is enable the website hosting feature. To do this, go to the properties tab and then click on the static website hosting option. And then simply change it to use this bucket to host a website option. And then I'm going to enter index.html as the default index document. And then I'm going to use Gatsby's default 404 page, 404.html, as the error document. One thing to take note of before you hit the save button is make sure and copy this endpoint at the top. You'll need this endpoint in the next step when we set up CloudFront. And finally, hit the save button to finalize our S3 bucket. Now let's create our CloudFront distribution. We'll go up to the services tab and go to CloudFront. And then we'll create a new distribution and for the web. And then for the origin domain name, make sure you paste in the URL that we copied from the previous step. Instead of using the one in this dropdown, the one in the dropdown is the S3 bucket URL, which is not the same. Okay, there are a few settings we want to set. The first is the viewer protocol policy. We don't want to allow HTTP, so we want to choose the redirect HTTP to HTTPS option. The next setting we want to update is the object caching setting. Since this is a static site, I would recommend updating the minimum, maximum, and default to a cache setting of as long as a year. So to do that, we'll click the Customize button, and then we'll copy the value for the maximum TTL to the minimum and default. This value represents the number of seconds in a year. The last thing we'll change is we'll set it to compress objects automatically. This will help with performance. We'll leave the rest of the settings the same and then scroll down and click the Create Distribution button. It can take about 10 to 20 minutes for AWS to deploy the distribution. I'm going to go ahead and skip ahead. And after 10 minutes, you'll see that the status has changed to deployed. Now let's get the files for our sample website ready to upload to the S3 bucket. I'm using Visual Studio Code as my code editor. And so I'm going to open up a terminal window within Visual Studio Code and then change to my project directory and then create a new out-of-the-box Gatsby site by running the Gatsby new command. I'm going to skip to the end of the creation process and then open up the folder it created in Visual Studio Code. So here's the out-of-the-box site it created. By default, you'll see if you go into the source directory, it creates a 404 page, a home page, and then a second page. Before we upload it to our S3 bucket, let's view it locally. To view it locally, just open up a terminal window and we'll run the Gatsby develop command. I'm going to fast forward again to the end of the build process. And then to view the page, we can just click on this link that it gives you. And here's our out-of-the-box Gatsby site running locally. Now let's run our production build to prepare our files to move up to our S3 bucket. To run the production build, just run the Gatsby build command. The Gatsby build command creates all the static files that we'll need to run our production site. I'm going to fast forward again, and once it's completed, we can go to the public directory and see the output of the Gatsby build command. Now let's move our files to the S3 bucket. So we'll go back to the AWS console and go to the S3 section, go into our bucket that we created, and then click on the upload button. And then let me open up the Windows Explorer side by side, and then we'll highlight all the files and drag them onto the upload dialog. And then click the upload button, and then it will upload all the files to the S3 bucket. Now let's go back to CloudFront and view our website. So we'll go back to CloudFront, open up our distribution. Under the domain name, we'll see our URL that we can then open up in the browser. And so there we go. We've got our static site hosted on an S3 bucket and served up by CloudFront. In today's video, we set up an S3 bucket in a CloudFront distribution to host a static site. In future videos, we'll talk about the next steps in making it ready for production. We'll cover setting up an SSL certificate and custom domain name, and go over how to automate the deployment of the code and deployment of the infrastructure to AWS. Thanks for watching today. If you found this video useful, give me a like and make sure and subscribe if you want more content on web best practices. Also, feel free to leave me a comment or question below and I'll try to respond to each one. Thanks.